This video is about steroid hormones, the concept of steroid hormone receptors, and the activity profiles of synthetic progestogens. These are the steroid hormones, and they are synthesized from cholesterol and all have the classic four-ring steroid structure. The steroid hormones can be divided into the corticosteroids and the sex hormones. The corticosteroids are so called because they are synthesized in the adrenal cortex of the adrenal glands, which are attached to the top of the kidneys. And there are two types of corticosteroids, the mineralocorticoids and the glucocorticoid steroids. Of the mineralocorticoid steroids, the main one is aldosterone. Aldosterone acts on the nephrons and regulates sodium and water retention. And that is the origin of the name mineralocorticoid. There is a synthetic mineralocorticoid drug called fludrocortisone, which is used for hormone replacement therapy in people with adrenal insufficiency. And spironolactone is an aldosterone receptor antagonist with potent anti-mineralocorticoid activity. Of the glucocorticoids, the main one is cortisol during times of increased energy requirements such as exercise or stress. Cortisol triggers the release of glucose into the bloodstream, and that is the origin of the name glucocorticoid. Glucocorticoids are also involved with lipid regulation, immune system regulation, and bone density. Cortisol is available in various PO and external formulations, where it is called hydrocortisone, and PO hydrocortisone is also used in adrenal insufficiency. There are numerous synthetic glucocorticoid analogs which are used in anti-inflammatory therapy, for example, prednisolone and dexamethasone. These are the sex hormones. There are three types of sex hormones: the progestogens, the estrogens, and the androgens. Of the progestogens, the main endogenous progestogen is progesterone. There are a few different estrogens, and the main ones are estradiol, estrane, and estriol. And the main androgen is testosterone. The sex hormones are mainly produced by the gonads, that is the ovaries and the testes, but small amounts are also produced by the adrenal cortex. If you go to Wikipedia and look up steroid hormones, you can find this image here. These are the pathways of synthesis of the different steroid hormones, starting from the mother compound cholesterol. I just wanted to show this to you because it shows that cholesterol has to be converted into a progestogen first before being converted into the final compound. So it's converted into a progestogen first before it's converted into either a glucocorticoid or a mineralocorticoid. And then to make the rest of the sex steroids, again, it has to go through progestogen first before it's converted into an androgen, and then finally into one of these estrogens. So each of these pathways is dependent on specific enzymes. So we've got aromatase here, and there are drugs which inhibit aromatase. And there are also drugs which inhibit 5-alpha reductase, for example, finasteride. So each hormone acts on their own steroid hormone receptor. So there is a progesterone receptor, estrogen receptors, androgen receptors, and so on. And there is some cross-activity between receptor types, which may be agonistic or antagonistic. For example, whilst the main action of progesterone is on the progesterone receptor, it also has a small amount of glucocorticoid activity, and it also has anti-androgenic, anti-estrogenic, and anti-mineralocorticoid activity. In contrast, the synthetic progestogens, also known as progestins, can vary from progesterone's steroid hormone receptor activity profile. For example, the early synthetic progestogens had androgenic activity and no anti-mineralocorticoid activity. androgenic activity is associated with hirsutism, acne, and lipid disorders. From this reference available online, it has this chart showing the different hormonal activity profiles of different progestins, progesterone, which is the endogenous progestogen, and it's showing it has some glucocorticoid activity and anti-mineralocorticoid activity, anti-androgen activity, and anti-estrogenic activity. In contrast, you can look at norethisterone, which was one of the first generation progestins. So this has some estrogenic activity and androgenic activity. And then we have levonorgestrel, which is commonly used in contraceptives, and it's showing that it has androgenic activity too. Here are some examples of commonly seen oral contraceptives. You can find out which progestogen they contain and use this chart to work out their hormone activity profile and see how this might relate to their adverse effects. Just so you know, an important adverse effect of oral contraceptives is thromboembolism, but this is related to the estrogen contents and will be discussed in a separate video.